Earlier in the show, we heard from Kiwis feeling the pinch in their back pocket. As the cost of living rapidly rises, they're adjusting to make do, but it's hard for so many. And they want their worries and concerns to be listened to by our government. So here to do that listening and to share her thoughts on that issue and other issues is Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern. Morena, Prime Minister, thanks for joining us. How are you this morning?
Oh, morena, Jenny May, not too bad.
OK, so can we talk about the cost of living? Food and grocery prices are at record highs, petrol prices the highest in 40 years, and everything is expected to get higher. Households, they're really struggling, Prime Minister. Are things at a critical point, do you think?
Well, yes, I do. For many families, they will be absolutely feeling the impact of now that, you know, that wicked perfect storm where we have the pressure of the economic recovery from a pandemic with a war on top. And so that is why today Cabinet will be considering additional things that we can do to try and ease the pressure. We're particularly concerned by those incredible increases that we're seeing at the pump as a result of the war in Ukraine. The reason I say additional, Jenny May, we recognised at the end of last year we had concerns around the fact that globally you're seeing everyone's economic recovery causing a big increase in demand, supply constraints, and also supply chain issues. We were worried about what that would do for the cost of living, and that's why on the 1st of April we have a package of things that are coming through. 60% of families will benefit from an increase in the family tax credit. We've got across-the-board benefit increases. We've got an increase for our super annuitants. And then on the 1st of May, you have the winter energy payment coming through, which also supports our super annuitants. But, as I say, we're looking at extra things that we can do at the same time because we are concerned.
So Cabinet will be considering that today. Are you able to tell us what those additional things are?
Not at this stage. I wouldn't mind giving the opportunity to Cabinet to have that conversation and look at all of those options, but we will look to move quickly. And so whilst I can't share too much detail right now, from 4 o'clock this afternoon, the outcome of those decisions we'll speak to on the podium right here in the Beehive Theatreette. We do want to move quickly because we know particularly that energy crisis we're seeing as a result of the war. You see, in a week, we've had incredible increases at the pump, and we know that will be causing a lot of pain. We cannot expect people to be able to change all of their habits around transport as quickly as we are seeing those prices increase.
Prime Minister, I'm going to push it a little bit here. I know that 4 p.m. the announcement will come, but will tax cuts be part of that? I mean, National suggesting exactly that on income and also on fuel. And I don't expect you to commit either way this morning, but an Auckland regional fuel tax, putting a freeze on that, wouldn't that help straight away? Wouldn't that help at the pumps? Wouldn't that help for families here in Tāmaki Makaurau?
Yeah. So just a couple of things. National have proposed cutting the top tax rate that sits at $180,000 plus currently. That is not the kind of initiative that we support right now. Now is not the time to be cutting taxes for those at those highest incomes that we have. Another point on the fuel tax, one of the things that we're really mindful of, and we are mindful of the cost of petrol in particular right now, so this is one of the things that we're going to talk about as a cabinet. But one of the things that we need to do at the same time is because every cent that comes from fuel excise goes straight into road maintenance, safety initiatives and roading projects, like for instance the Eastern Busway, things that give you alternative options, those are gaps that need to be plugged. You can't just take it off and then leave nothing. So those are the kinds of things as a team we need to talk about. How do we plug those gaps that will exist if you remove them?
People feel like they're not being listened to, Prime Minister. At 4 o'clock this afternoon, do you think there will be some relief for those people who are struggling, for those families, for those households that are struggling?
I think the one thing that I would... We're looking to move very quickly here because we're seeing the same thing that every New Zealander is seeing right now. you know, the war is impounding an already existing problem that we had globally with pandemic recovery. It's created this wicked perfect storm. But the one thing I would say, Jenny May, is that, you know, we were hearing this before now as well. We wouldn't have that package of initiatives coming in on the 1st of April if we didn't already have a concern around the cost of living. What we're looking at now is what an addition that we can do on top of that. But that 1st of April package is a significant one for many of our low and middle income earners. But at the same time, we are particularly concerned about what's happening to petrol prices.
Can we talk about the border? We had a couple of tourist operators on earlier this morning who are wanting that border opened to international travellers earlier than October. Is that a possibility? Because some of them won't make it through this winter.
It is. The first thing to say is, of course, New Zealanders can come home, and they can come home now from anywhere in the world and not isolate. What we've also just seen the reopening of over the weekend is that our working holiday visa holders can also come into the country now. So what we've been doing is gradually reopening in the safest way possible. But we've already said we will bring forward those other reopening dates. So Australians just generally were due to come in July, visa waiver countries as well thereafter. We're looking to bring those forward because we believe we can safely do so. We'll be looking to make announcements on the timeframes for that this week.
So earlier than October, but you can't give me any indication because,
yes,
you know, again,
absolutely,
tourism operators,
absolutely,
they just want some clarity.
So absolutely, it will be. It was already earlier than October. October was the latest for the final phase of reopening.
Yep.
And so it was really from mid this year that we were seeing tourism and tourists really start to begin again. It will be earlier than that. And to give you a general sense, we've already said that the point that we're coming off the peak of Omicron, when we start to see hospitalisations normalise, that pressure on our health system ease, is when the experts have said that they believe it would be possible to reopen the borders more widely. But we'll be making the announcements this week on what exactly those dates look like.
Prime Minister, can we take a look at what the situation that's happening in the Ukraine? Last week, Parliament passed the Russia Sanctions Act. Now, the first tranche of sanctions were being worked on and expected to be in place this week. Can you give us an update on where things are at?
Yeah, so you're absolutely right. Now that we have that bill, we have the ability then to add additional sanctions on individuals, entities, assets. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade are looking at what needs to be included in that first range. But I think the point I'll make here is that we'll be rolling. You're seeing with other countries as well, they might release a first blush and then they continue to add individuals as new intelligence is found. Our law allows us to do the same. We are absolutely in step with what other countries are doing right now. Now, though, there's no view that, for instance, New Zealand hasn't done what's required. Absolutely, we have, and we will continue to do so. So I expect in the next week we'll have some extra elements to add once we've gone through that process. We'll then delve a little more deeply into where there may not be the same intelligence that we need in order to assess specific individuals that are relevant to New Zealand, so that will take some time thereafter.
Prime Minister, as always, we appreciate your time. Thanks so much. Tēnā koe.